Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at ways of dealing with large iPhoto libraries. So I occasionally get emails from people having trouble with their iPhoto library, and they usually come to the conclusion very quickly that their iPhoto library is too big. But iPhoto can hold a ton of photos. Some say it can hold as many as 250,000 photos. So if you've got less than that, then chances are there are some other steps you could take to speed things up, make things run a little smoother. One thing is people don't realize that iPhoto has a separate trash from the rest of your system. If you go and select a image and then trash it, hit the delete key, it seems to be gone, but it's actually still stored in your iPhoto library. And you can find it by going to trash here, and it'll show you the photos you've recently thrown in the trash. So it's still stored there, so you're not going to get any space back by just doing that. This is kind of a safety measure, just like the regular trash. So if you accidentally throw something away, you can come back to it and recover it. If you want to really empty the trash and clear out space from your library, you go to iPhoto and empty iPhoto trash. And that'll get rid of these. Of course, you want to make sure, absolutely sure, that you really want to delete them, because there's really no way to get them back after doing that. Another thing you may want to do is try to rebuild the iPhoto library. Your iPhoto library may be very old, go back years, several versions of iPhoto. All sorts of things could have happened during that time to create a little more bulk in there than there should be, things that haven't been cleaned up. And rebuilding it solves a lot of problems. So the way to do that is first you quit iPhoto. Then you launch iPhoto again, but when launching, hold down the Command and the Option keys and keep them held down. And then when it launches, you'll see that you get this dialog box here that gives you options for rebuilding the library. So there's all sorts of things you can do. If you know you're having a problem with your thumbnails or something like that, then you could go to one of these. But the ultimate one is to rebuild the database. Now before doing this, one of the things I would do is make sure you're backed up. You're using Time Machine Backup, of course, so you want to make sure that that has recently run in the last few minutes. And also you can go to your iPhoto library here, usually in your Pictures folder unless you put it somewhere else, and you can make a copy of it. You can put it on an external drive, put it somewhere else on your drive if you have plenty of space. Just make a duplicate of this, so that if something goes wrong, that you've got your photos. Nothing's really going to go wrong, very rare, but your photos are too valuable to take that chance. So returning to iPhoto, you then select Rebuild Database and hit Rebuild. The process may take some time, so maybe do that just before lunch or before you're done using your computer for the evening. Now another thing people try to do sometimes is split their iPhoto library into multiple pieces. I don't recommend this, because the whole point of having all your photos one place is be able to find them. If I want to find pictures of my daughter's third birthday, I don't have to search my iPhoto library before I realize, oh wait, that was before a certain year. That means I have to open a different iPhoto library. So I don't like the idea of doing that. But say if you use iPhoto for work and you do projects, you know, say you do photo shoots, things like that, and stuff you don't necessarily want to be in the same place as everything else, then you could start new libraries. The way to deal with new libraries is just like before, you quit iPhoto and you launch iPhoto again, but this time just holding down the Option key. And this time you'll get this dialog box here where you can actually go in and create a new iPhoto library. And once you have multiple iPhoto libraries, you can choose which library you want to open up. So say you do want to split up your iPhoto library. Well, how would you do that? Well, you go to where your iPhoto library is located, and you can simply duplicate it, make a copy of it, and then you go into one and you delete some photos from that one, and you go into the second one and you delete some photos from that one. So for instance, if you have photos from 2011 and 2012, you can have one copy where you delete everything from 2012 and another copy where you delete everything from 2011. And now you've got two separate libraries, each with 1 year. You want to make sure that you empty the trash in each one, and that you also maybe rebuild the library when you're done, since you're deleting so many photos from it. But it's one way to do it. There's also some third-party software you can search for. I've never tried it, that will divide up an iPhoto library. And you can also use Aperture for this. I'll look at handling this kind of thing in Aperture in a future episode. Another thing you may want to do is to get the videos out of your iPhoto collection. A lot of times I hear about huge collections, and it turns out most of it's video files, which are much larger than photos. And you take videos in your iPhone on your digital camera, they come into iPhoto and they take up a ton of space, and a lot of people would rather store them in a folder somewhere else and name them properly, things like that. So you can do that using image capture. Take the videos off of your iPhone and off of your digital camera first and then sync with iPhoto to get the photos imported into there. But if you already have photos in iPhoto, you can find them easily by creating a smart album and then setting it to be things like file name contains and then putting all the extensions that are typically used for videos. So I'm going to do just three here, but you can do more if it turns out your camera is generating files with a different name. Just match any of the following conditions. OK. And then you can see here it grabs two videos there. And I could take these videos and I could drag and drop them to a folder here in the Finder to export them very easily. So I can export them all from there. And then I can delete them from my iPhoto collection. And if you want to trash these, what you need to do is select them all from there and then move to trashes, grayed out. But if you hold down the Option key, then you can actually move these to the trash and delete them. So there are a few ways to speed up iPhoto if you're having trouble. A few things you should try. Definitely try everything before deciding to split up your iPhoto library. And of course, another option is to move to Aperture, which I'll be looking at in a future episode. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. And go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.